all. It gives me great pleasure this evening on behalf of Mr. Palmara to host Venkatesh Ramakrishnan. I don't think Venkatesh needs an introduction to most of you here. Venkatesh is...
And if you like scandals.
Yeah, scandals. So, when Venkatesh and I were discussing what the topic should be, and he said, elephants or Madras as a stop. I said, two of my favorite things in one sentence, that's it, okay, no more thinking beyond that. So this evening, we are really, really happy and excited to present this topic, elephants, the advent of elephants in Chennai for the last 300 years. It's going to be super interesting. I think it's the first time he's doing a talk on this topic. Yeah. Okay. So most of you also wouldn't have heard this before, I guess. In any case, like for those who haven't heard about Venkatesh, this is the intro. So Venkatesh Ramakrishnan is a bilingual novelist, historian, and columnist. His Gods, Kings, and States was the best-selling historical novel published by Hachette. He has also written three historical novels in Tamil, one of them being the sequel to Kalki's Pollin's Selvam, entitled Kaveri and Maithil. How many of you have read this? He writes a weekly column on Madras during the 40s in his paper. He also founded the largest social media group on Madras history called the Madras Local History Group, which has nearly 20,000 members. He believes in crowdsourcing of historical civics to add to the historical fabric of the city. He founded the Kuam Cultural Mapping Group to understand the history and culture of the river turning into a sewer. He is a member in the winning team of Water as a Leverage in Resilient Asia, a Dutch climate initiative. The team, over the course of the next 9 months, will analyze and build partnerships and develop conceptual designs and proposals for groundbreaking innovative urban climate and water projects of their cities. Venkatesh conducts heritage walks, gives lectures mainly on Madras during the 40s and conducts historical tours. And the most important thing is that his family owned an elephant and they were cooking. So I'm sure this is very good topic, good. So without much ado, ladies and gentlemen, I present Venkatesh Ramakrishnan.
Yeah, thank you. Madras did not, whatever people say, Madras did not exist in the same condition, say 500 years back. Every piece of its history is migrant history. The men came, I came, or my father came, or my grandfather came. If I was lucky, my great grandfather came. The same way the elephants also came. So everything has, the migrant history is very interesting because more than the history of people who are born in a place. You have lots of interesting tales and that's how you get scandals. But today it's going to be a very, very, let me say, it's a very vegetarian talk. None like the ones I previously gave. So, I hope you are not disappointed. See, elephants have always fascinated people because of their size, because men could control them. These are the different versions of the six men, six blind men and an elephant in different civilizations. We source it from different civilizations, and it's almost a fable in almost every country in the world. For a city that had no native elephants within 200 miles, Madras has a long and interesting history of pachyderm chronicles. The British brought elephants to Madras, though they might have been an odd one in Chola or Vijayanagar times. The Pallavas, of course, had elephants. They did a huge study of elephants in Mamallapuram. In 5 years, it will come into your mega city plan, so that's a part of Madras as well. So, in Tamil, there are 11 words to denote an elephant in, according to size or sex or age. So, you could say that or inherent part of Tamil culture, right? Sivagami in Sabadam, Kalki describes two major events in Kanchipuram. One is the elephants attacking the fort. This is actually the elephant proof gate. It's not here, it's in Pune. Sanivar or something, okay. So, elephant mele eppadi avanga spears throw pannangana, that is 7th century, 8th century. So, we have a lot of knowledge about elephants in warfare in and around Madras. This, elephants are fascinating more in lands where they are not native. This elephant was called Hano, or a corruption of the word Yane. It was not shipped from Madras, but it's a very important elephant in the world history. This was gifted by the Portuguese to the Pope. The Pope Leo was so fascinated by this that he spent almost all his waking hours with the elephant. He did not bother how things went. That was exactly the time Martin Luther was starting the Protestant movement in Germany. And a lot of the split in Christianity is often blamed on this elephant. This elephant died of constipation, and some quack gave it a gold-based medicine, which the Pope was willing to give, and it died and is buried on Vatican Hill. It was painted by Raphael. Michelangelo came to see these things, and some of his sketches might be influenced by this. So Madras as an entity is around 300 years old, 500 if you include the Portuguese, Santom. This is a copy from a page in the port master's book. See, at least two of these ships have elephants. One came with 14 elephants, one came with 6 elephants. So elephants were needed for wars, temples, logging. More so, the rulers of Indian states wanted elephants in their stables to exhibit their power and pelf. Some buildings in India had a double-height portico. We will be seeing that the somewhere coming behind. And the buildings were built with a double-height portico so that the elephants could walk in with their howdahs. They were designed that way. Elephants often moved from place to place, even country to country, and Madras was always the pivotal point of the elephant trade. If Madras is suthi ivlovu elephants irundappo, would we expect Madras to be an exporter of elephants or an importer of elephants? For the first 300 years, Madras was an importer of elephants. Elephants are not being caught and transported to Madras from the Coorg or from the Konganadu, because they did not breed in captivity and they died. Their death rate was very high in captivity. So it is easier to import an elephant from Burma or Thailand, and shiploads of elephants came into Madras. So we expect the East India Company to have exported elephants. On the contrary, the company that ruled Madras for most of its history was an importer of elephants. The English East India Company trade to Southeast Asia from the Coromandel, considered mainly export of textile. Hundreds of elephants were shipped every year from Pegu, Tenasserim, I don't know what the place is today, and Malacca. The company did try trapping elephants but did not work out. Many died in captivity and the import was more profitable. So this is a Masula boat. Madras did not have a harbour for a lot of time, and the ship stopped 2 miles away from the shore, and people had to be transported in this Masula boats, including Mem Sahibs. A lot of Mem Sahibs complained of being pinched by the men who lifted them into the water. So when Mem Sahib nelamaye aprina, who would want to lift an elephant from there to here? So what exactly happened was, the elephants would be pushed into water and made to swim the last 2 kilometers. This happened for the first 150 years. An elephant coming into Madras was swimming the Bay of Bengal for nearly 2 kilometers before stepping on land. Then of course came the rafts.
They built rafts, that's the fire.
They built came, and they used to make rafts, and from the ship they used to load the elephant onto the raft and onto the beach. It's a very famous photograph. If this was it, we have contemporary reports of how elephants were loaded on in Ceylon or Malacca. First you have to make a raft, then they must be covered with grass and branches of palm trees, otherwise the elephants won't go there. Once the elephants went there, they were blindfolded, then they were lifted by cranes, they were lifted by cranes onto the ships. Or important thing is, if one of the elephants died without making much of a noise, they used to cut it into pieces and throw it into the sea. Because if the rest of the elephants knew that it had died, they would not eat it, seems. These are all coming in the reports of the masters of the ships. Once the port came, Madras became an exporter of elephants. We started exporting elephants mainly to Andamans. So let us talk about Madras and the elephants. There are many references to the elephant within the Fort St. George. 1685, British King Charles II died, but the news came 6 months later, along with the news that his son James had become the king. So immediately he was proclaimed king. In a spontaneous show of loyalty, the natives of Blacktown, under the leadership of Petty Nayak, must have been Petty Nayak, had elephants carrying British flags, following drummers and their kettle drums, and marched into the town. This is one of the earliest references of elephants in the Blacktown as well as the fort. Adhe madri, when the wall around Blacktown was built, that was a big scandal, a lot of corruption in that. Or L-shaped wall, and the wall tax road, you would have heard of it. And there is a gate, one of the only gate named after an elephant is called the Elephant Gate. Invariably, the street opposite is called Elephant Gate Street. The earlier maps of Madras Patha, we see an elephant garden and an elephant street there. இதில் தான் இந்த லொரைன்ஸ் பகோடான்னு ஒரு டெம்பிள் இருக்குது. அது இந்த பைரகி டெம்பிள் ஆர் மட்டன் இப்போ சொல்கிறாங்க. தட் இஸ் வாட் முத்தையா ஐடென்டிஃபைஸ் இட் ஆஸ் தோ இட் இஸ் ஆன் என்எஸ்சி போஸ் ரோட். அங்கே தான் வந்து இஃப் யூ ஹேப்பன் டு கோ தேர் அ சைட் ஆஃப் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் மெட்ராஸில் ஓல்டஸ்ட் துளசி மடம் இஸ் தட் மட் ஓல்டஸ்ட் எக்ஸிஸ்டிங் யூ ஷுட் சி தேட். லொரைன்ஸ் பகோடான்னு இருக்குது. பட் நாட் ஏபிள் டு எனக்கு வந்து ஐ தாட் இட் த கந்த நாட் த கந்தகோட்டம் த குமார கோட்டம் வாஸ் க்ளோசர் டு தேட் எலிஃபென்ட் ஸ்ட்ரீட் in the map, but a lot of roads have got fudged. Elephants of Nawab of Arcot used to be stabled alongside a pond and they were washed in a place called Anaikulam. Innikum vayasanavanga triplicate they call it Anaikulam, that place which is the ISO's police station which was burned down during the Jallikattu riots. And that thing is called a howda. It makes the elephant much taller and much inconvenient to get down. Or the So a lot of buildings including WCC and a lot of Nawab of Arcot's palaces had a double portico. A double portico where the elephant used to walk in and they used to get down in the first floor. Straight walk into the first floor. So this building is still there. This is the Doughton building. A very famous building where Tipu Sultan's sons were imprisoned. We also had a Gaikwad from Baroda who tried to poison the British resident with diamond powder. Tamil cinema la they commit suicide with diamond. Adhe maadhiri he ground diamond and gave it in sharbat to the British resident and he got sick. Apra or trial periya trial vachu they sent him into exile in Madras and he lived for the rest of his life in WCC in that. So this is the Theosophical Society and nothing much about this, but it was very, it's a big challenge to have an elephant in Madras. You needed 600 pounds of grass daily. This is from a East India Company account. 600 pounds of grass daily. The elephant, the mahout and the grass cutter cost 48 rupees in Madras. It cost half of that in Bengal. But in Genmo, it was double the cost. Elephants roamed around in Madras till the 80s in temples and festivals and begging. In fact, Madras Veterinary College is one of the very few colleges in the world which offers a master's degree in elephant management. So that photo, and look at the boy who was afraid of the elephant. Hindu land. And the tale with Masalamaneshwarar in Thirumulai Vail has mentioned the elephant, the Stalapuranam. The king goes around in an elephant. Elephant oda kaal la vandu the mullai kodi vandu sikkudu. Adha cut pandrappa blood comes out and they find a lingam and build the temple. So Thirumulai Vail oda, this is one of the earliest references to an elephant in Madras. To the British, the elephant always signified India. Elephant vandu nammalaal control panna mudiyra maari India nammalaal control panna mudiyudhu. So the elephant under is India under captivity. So most of the places when they signify India in a book or something, the elephant irukum nichayam irukum. There were paintings of East India Company officials going on in elephants. And a general curiosity also, there are many poems about elephants in England at the time. The East India Company was ordered to bring birds, deer and other animals for the Far East for James I. James of Park ingra edathila vachirundanga. His pleasure even extended to an elephant and some camels. Public eye, they were open to the public also, they could come and see. His wife was an avid collector of animals. The point is, she had 8 elephants, some of which could have come from Madras. Maintaining an elephant in England in the cold was very tough. But unfortunately, historians, she also had the first zebra in Europe. And unfortunately, the historians started punning on the word and she was made fun of, the queen's ass. And as the East India Company enlarged its operations in the Far East, elephants began arriving in England in ever increasing numbers. And each voyage used to take 6 months to 1 year. And maintaining an elephant on the high seas was a very big problem on the seas. And sometimes not all elephants arrived. One elephant intended for the second Duke of Richmond from Madras had a spectacular end. Before it could be disembarked on Blackwall in Thames, அங்கே வந்து ஒரு ஸ்பார்க் ஃப்ரம் அ கேண்டில் ஃபெல் ஆன் சம் பேக்ஸ் ஆஃப் சால்ட் பெட்டர் அண்ட் த ஷிப் எக்ஸ்ப்ளோடட் அந்த எலிஃபென்ட் வாஸ் இன்ஸ் பேர்ன் டு டெத் ஈவன் காட் தி டிடன்ட் ஈவன் கெட் த போன்ஸ் அவுட். ஸோ இந்த ஸ்டோரிஸ் ஆஃப் த எலிஃபென்ட் டையிங் ஆன் த போட்டில் அந்த காலத்தில் இட் வாஸ் ரிப்போர்ட்டட் இந்த நியூஸ் பேப்பர்ஸ். பொயம்ஸ் வர் ரிட்டன் அபவுட் தட். In the temple on the, I think it must be Tirumulai Vail. Look, the pond and this, because this is about, it's Gant's drawing of elephant in Madras. Gant's family, father and two sons, they lived in India and did a lot of paintings. They were of Austrian extraction, and the Gant's press in Madras was the first lithographic press in India. The three people, the father and two sons, they had this press in Madras. They drew and then they had it printed there. It's not very clear, but Queen Victoria had a golden jubilee la, or in Madras la, or speech padichittu that was given in a casket to her, made of silver. The silver casket in which the presidential address of Madras was given to Queen Victoria on her golden jubilee, 1887. PR and Sons made it. It was designed by Chisholm, the architect who does the Indo-Saracenic buildings. Oxidized silver elephant. Along with 17 inches and 10 inches, just for details. And this also had the, was presented with a narrative of the celebration of Her Majesty's Jubilee in Madras. Anna, when we go through this, we see every important event of the British royal family being celebrated with great this in Madras. 1911 la coronation ukkunda, there was a competition held by Muthialpet Sabha to write a Sanskrit poem on the coronation. The winning prize is Rama and Sita to protect the Chakravarti and Chakravartini. The last lines, they got a gold coin. Madras was a very loyal town. We can't, we had to, in 40s, we had to invent a lot of heroes to make up with the rest of the states. So, Queen Victoria, we can see Devakotela, we can see 10, 12 arches for Victoria and on the golden jubilee of hers. With Queen Victoria, like Elizabeth, much to the exasperation of her son and grandson, lived very, very long. So, the British went on lots of picnics and travels. They enjoyed the elephant, and the size was what was it was under our control, and it boosted their ego a lot. And of course, elephants were also used for hunting. And when royalty came, this was Prince of Wales. He traveled all over the, India, even in Madras, on elephants. Idhu was in a recent auction. There's a small elephant here in silver. East India Company flintlock musket with an elephant and crown went for a very big price. And another important thing was, scientists, biologists were very, very curious on how the system of the elephant worked. How big was his heart? How big was his liver? How could blood be pumped over such a big body? So everybody wanted to dissect an elephant. So Versailles Palace, before the king, they dissected an elephant. Same time, like Fort St. George, they dissected an elephant. So I just read about the report. Many dissections of dead elephants were performed throughout the world in 17th and 18th centuries. One done in Versailles Palace with Louis XIV in attendance. One such dissection was recorded in Madras Fort St. George and drew worldwide attention. One of the earliest dissections of elephants, and it has been quoted for a long place. It was a very grueling task. November 1715, long winded 12-hour procedure at Fort St. George. A French surgeon, A. Supply, examined the carcass of a gigantic specimen and mused upon its inner workings. The creature had been dead only for 24 hours and had not started to rot. Challenging though the task was, he was not alone. The government had given him 20 assistants to help him. They helped him with hooks. And our Nidharana, at every time they used to run and have a bath in the nearby river, must have been the Kuom. Clean. Fort St. George, they went and had a bath occasionally because it is getting very hot. My Indians found a great heat issuing from the entrails and viscera. It was something somewhat singular and diverting to see this native anatomist go in and out of the belly of this terrestrial whale like Jonas to wash themselves from the blood and filth in the nearby river. That's what he says. So, 1942, when the Japanese were bombing Madras, were about to bomb Madras, they just bombed it for one day. When they were going to bomb Madras, one of the fears of the people was, what if the bomb escaped? This was a fear that was all throughout the world. Most of the zoos shot their animals. Some, like Berlin, did not and suffered because RAF bombed the zoo and they had to hunt the panthers and the tigers road to road. So Madras Zoo, they decided to shoot all the lions, tigers, the hyenas, the bears. The elephant, they allowed to live. The reason being, they did not have enough manpower to bury it. So the elephant survived for 2 to 3 days and was sent to Erode by train. And the Madras Zoo never recovered after that. On the People's Park, the zoo, the MGR, the Orever Palilla, the Singh, so it was that அவர் அந்த அடிமை பெண்ணில் சண்டை போடுவார் அந்த சிங்கத்தோட, அந்த குரல் அதுதான் கடைசி வரைக்கும் இருந்தது. வண்டலூருக்கு போனதுக்கப்புறம் தான் இட் பிகேம் ஒரு டீசென்ட் ஜூ டு கோ டு. எலிஃபன்ஸ் அஃப்கோர்ஸ் வேர் பிஃபோர் திஸ் த வார் மிஷின்ஸ். இந்தியா வாஸ் கான்கர்ட் பை எலிஃபன்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் வந்த கேனன்ஸ் கேம் வி குட் ஈவன் யூ கேன் சி வென் லோடி அண்ட் பாபர் ஃபாட் தட் த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஃபேஸ் ஆஃப் வார் ஹட் கம் இன். எலிஃபன்ட்ஸ் நோ லாங்கர் குட் பி த வார் மிஷின். So British when they saw the earlier kings, Britons had to battle with the elephants and they soon adopted that into their army. At one point the British had 1500 war elephants, much of it in Madras Presidency. In fact, if the elephants were not there, the British would have lost the Sipahi mutiny. The elephants carried their artillery pieces, pulled their artillery pieces and their ammunition over long distances, over very very tough terrains. Historians today say but for the elephants the history could have changed in 1857. So this is Arcot. Now when I always much to the anger of a lot of my friends, I call Clive the Yuga Purushan. As a historian we should not take sides. Who is the Yuga Purushan? And the time la vandu history should change, he should be born when he is changing history or he can. So what exactly happens is I'll have to go into Clive's history for this. And Clive, when the French capture Madras, they take a lot of people including the governor of Madras, the president of the fort St George, as hostages to Pondicherry where they are ransomed. Clive is not even worth a ransom. Pondicherry kaaru kootin pora selavukku kuda is not worth it, so he is left back. Clive jumps over the wall, wades over the Kuom river, walks to Kadalur in 4 days, starts the Indian army, the first unit of the Indian army, and builds a British empire. So the day a company becomes an empire was the day Clive escaped. Clive vandu Kadalur la irukkaru. அப்போ வந்து ஆர்காட்லேருந்து த ஆர்மி ஆஃப் ஆர்காட் கோஸ் டு ட்ரிச்சி டு அட்டாக் அ ஃப்ரெண்ட் ஆஃப் அ பார்ட் ஆஃப் திஸ் ஆர்காட் ஃபேமிலி வாஸ் அ ஃப்ரெண்ட் ஆஃப் த பிரிட்டிஷ் அலாங் த ஃப்ரெஞ்ச். அப்போ கிளைவ் கிவ்ஸ் அன் ஐடியா, வி டோன்ட் ஹவ் இனஃப் கைஸ் டு கோ அண்ட் கான்கர் ஃபைட் த ஆர்மி இன் ட்ரிச்சி, வில் ரேதர் கோ டு ஆர்காட் விச் ஹஸ் பீன் எம்டிட் நோ கேப்சர் இட். ஸோ கிளைவ் டஸ் இட் வித்வுட் ஃபயரிங் அ ஷார்ட், ஹி கேப்சர்ஸ் ஆர்காட். உடனே தட் ஆர்மி ஃப்ரம் ஜஸ்ட் ஹஸ் ஹி பிளான்ட் ஆர்மி ஃப்ரம் ட்ரிச்சி இஸ் டேர்ன் பேக் திஸ் சைட் அண்ட் the Nawab has the unfortunate unhappiness of laying a siege to his own fort. He is outside and Clive is inside. For 51 days they battered the fort with elephants. They shot at the Arcot fort. It almost became Clive held on to the fort. Clive vandu oru avlo periya manushana vaanadhukku in spite of the elephants he held on. That story became 1 became 10, 10 became 1000, and by the time it reached England Clive was this Yuga Purushan that I always talk about. The elephants எல்லாம் வந்து ரொம்ப லேட்டாக வந்து கிளைவ் ஹிஸ்டரியில், பட் இட் வாஸ் பேட்டரிங். உள்ள இருக்குது பிரிட்டிஷ் ஆர்மி, வெளியே இருக்குது பிரெஞ்சு ஆர்மி. தட் ஹி மேனேஜ் டு ஹோல்ட் த ஃபோர்ட் என்ஹான்சிங் இஸ் ஸ்டாண்டிங். தோ த எலிஃபென்ட் வாஸ் ஸ்லோலி பீங் ஃபேஸ்ட் அவுட் ஆன் த ஆர்மிஸ், த எலிஃபென்ட்ஸ் யூஸ் எலிஃபென்ட்ஸ் த பிரிட்டிஷ் யூஸ் எலிஃபென்ட்ஸ் டு புல் தர் ஹெவி ஆர்டிலரி, த ஹியூஜ் கன்ஸ் அண்ட் எலிஃபென்ட்ஸ் விச் புல் தெம் டு பொசிஷன் ஹெல்ப் தம் ஷேட்டர் ஃபோர்ட்ஸ், கான்கர் த சப்கான்டினென்ட் இன் அ ரேபிட் பேஸ். அசோசியேட்டிங் த எலிஃபென்ட் வித் ஆல் திங்ஸ் இண்டியன், the British designed the logo of the Madras regiment. The Madras regiment was started in Kadalur. The Madras regiment, the parent of the Indian army, was started in Kadalur. I was just talking to Priya about a colonial trip that she should do. The Indian army was started in Kadalur in Fort David. We still have the building next to the backwater where the Madras regiment was first banded together, and the logo on there has an elephant. So the importance that the first regiment of the Madras Indian Army has an elephant, it is called Asai elephant, where this was given to the Madras regiment after they defeated the Marathas. They were outnumbered 1:10 and they defeated the Marathas in the big war. Asai anga vanda, then this was given to them. Another important war history of Madras is the Battle of Adyar. Our children know about Battle of Panipat, they know about Battle of everything, plus they don't know about the Battle of Adyar. People living in Mandavali were will be living in the battlefields. So the point is, when we have 300 people on the Quibble Island from the French, led by a Paradis who is a Swiss general, and 10,000 people of the Arcot army on this side, both with similar weapons were not different like the Mughal army, arithmetic will tell you that the 10,000 will win, but history will tell you the 300 can also win, and the truth says the 300 won. And when the 300 crossed the river, the Arcot Nawab's son, Mahfuz Khan, was seated on an elephant, sure of victory. And the elephant got so terrified that it turned and ran all the way to Kundratur. It ran so fast that he lost his shirt. I think the Tundakanam Tuniyakanam term came with Mahfuz Khan. The Battle of Adayar changed the Indian history because the Europeans realized that the army, however small it was, if it was organized, could beat a much bigger army. So, Battle of Adayar, the next time you cross Foreshore Estate, Mandavelli or Kibble Island, think of this great war that happened. And incidentally, when I am coming so close, the last elephants in a war were used in Vietnam. Okay, they were so effective in transporting things for the Viet Cong that the US Army actually said they are legal to be killed. That is, they are legal targets. Elephants, the last time. Of course, hunting. Elephants participated on both sides of the hunt. They were hunted and they were used for hunts, depending on the time. It was an exciting sport for the colonial government officials. Lord Curzon vandu or letter eduvar. Implored a friend of his to come and stay with us. We will arrange for you to shoot tigers from the back of elephants or elephants from the back of a tiger. So, that was a changeover of the time when elephants were also being used for hunts. இது வந்து ஒரு ஒரு எலிஃபென்ட் ஹண்டர் ரைட்ஸ் அபவுட் திஸ் டு ஸ்டாண்ட் அப் வித்இன் 10 பேசஸ் அண்ட் ட்ராப் அன் எலிஃபென்ட் டெட் பிஃபோர் ஹி இஸ் அவேர் ஆஃப் டேஞ்சர் இஸ் த போயட்ரி ஆஃப் த ஸ்போர்ட் டு கில் இம் வித் அ பாடி ஷாட்ஸ் இஸ் த ப்ரோஸ் ஸோ அந்த மாதிரி இருந்தது தேர் லாட் ஆஃப் டாக்ஸி டெமிஸ் இன் மெட்ராஸ் அனிமல் ஸ்டஃபர்ஸ் இன் மெட்ராஸ் மவுண்ட் ரோட்ல எகின்பாத்தம் பக்கத்தில் இருந்தாங்க வேர் ஆல் த அனிமல்ஸ் இன்க்ளூடிங் டைகர்ஸ் அண்ட் எலிஃபென்ட் ஹெட்ஸ் ஆல்மோஸ்ட் எவ்ரி ஹவுஸ் இன் ஃபோர்ட் செயின்ட் ஜார்ஜ் ஹேட் அன் எலிஃபென்ட் ஹெட் வித் ட்ரங்க் ஸ்டஃப் வித் காயர் ரபித் And a lot of, this is the skinning in South India, William Temple, elephant being skinned. Elephants offered a lot of hunting mementos other than ivory. Many Madras houses had stuffed elephant heads done up by expert taxidermists on the walls. Elephants' feet held umbrellas, footstools, and the private parts of tuskers were made into golf bags. So that was happening in Madras. And for animal lovers like Priya, Madras was the first place in the world to ban elephant hunting. We had a rule in 1873, the Preservation of Act of Madras Presidency, elephant preservation, which was copied word by word throughout the world. And first the copy panna the other presidencies, then of course Ceylon copied it. And the first person to break the law was the heir apparent of the English throne. He came on a trip to Sri Lanka. I didn't bake it in Madras. Sri Lanka, he came and shot an elephant because people told him, our king, you should come and kill an elephant. He was the first person to break that law. Then, of course, elephants were used for hunting other animals. They felt a little relatively safe when you were hunting a tiger or something. So, in cinema, I also have a small videos on this. This is Ellis Duncan, the American in Madras. He always used to say that I was going to go back after this film. And he never stayed in a house. He used to stay in a hotel, Amjad Bagh, that is IOB, there was a hotel with a lion cub as a pet. One night the lion cub escapes, goes into Mount Road and the police almost shoot it. And somebody says, Dorey or a single kutti, and all don't. Then it is taken back. It used to be tied to a tree when he went for shooting. Duncan, the 30s and 40s, is a remarkable person. Who introduced a lot of things to Indian cinema. Somebody must have done it, but he did it. First is makeup, proper makeup. The trolley was called the Duncan trolley for a long time. And he also introduced the cabaret dance. The cabaret dance till the 1975-80 was an inherent part of any Indian cinema. So Duncan, this is Narasimha Bharathi in one of his movies. And romba intimate scenes. And people including Kalki used to write about how he was corrupting the people of Tamil Nadu. But Kalki, when he starts producing a movie, chooses Duncan to direct it. Invariably, Meerak on the Duncan is chosen. So Duncan
was also the first person, perhaps
entire Indian cinema history, to introduce elephants in a shot. Actually, it's not very clear. The video is on YouTube. 1937 la. Chola Karikalan coming into his capital Urayur after a successful campaign, a series of elephants, 10-12 elephants come in that. One of the earliest cinemas, perhaps the first cinema to show elephants in a talkie. This of course is Vanamohini, one of the famous, this was Thaumani Devi. She came from Sri Lanka. Thaumani Devi is now very often talked about in Madras history as the first liberated heroine. She used to design her own dress, write her own English songs. She used to design very dresses of very little expense to the producer. The producer would be alarmed that the censors would be hurt. And the first one there, sometimes you make a mistake in casting. She is cast as Ahalya in a movie. And the movie flops. Naturally, it will flop. With Thaumani as Ahalya, it will flop. So she, remember, Kadupula, she goes back to Sri Lanka. And when a jungle movie is being made, they want a heroine, very pretty heroine who is willing to act well. And the producer actually goes to Sri Lanka to see the heroine. He is fascinated by her. She comes back. And first press conference, la, she creates a riot by handing over her photograph in a bikini to all the press guys. So, and the maadhiri padam vachu padathai eduthadhu.
This is the irony. You take the movie.
It's a jungle movie with a scantily clad heroine and you're going to make a hit of it now. No? The producers were a little scared and Chandru the Tusker is first in the cast. The MK Radha, adhukapra Thaumani. They are so insecure and they are sure that the elephant would bring in the crowds rather than the heroine. So, this is an insult to Thaumani because MGR or a first padam Rajakumar iliye Thaumani is taken in so that she can bring in the crowds. People say that people came to see the viewers came in to see Thaumani and not MGR and they went back with MGR in the heart. So a very famous story in Tamil as well as religious, how in the Valli Thirumanathila, how the elephant plays a role. Gopi, you might have to play the first video. This was shot in the Theosophical Society. Yeah, Rukmani, I'll talk about. Oh, and the Alamarala on the full Theosophical Society. Yanya Marungo. The language is typically a Tambram language in 1940s. Everybody spoke it. You can put it off. In fact, or Jnana Soundari, or a Christian movie. Citadel Studios had made a very good movie. It was running in the theatres. And Vasan or assistants like Kothamangalam Subbu and Vepathur Kittu, they told him, Nammal on the Kadai Edukala, Jnana Soundari Edukala. Already theatre la odin irukkepana. Lala, Gemini Peruk Voro. We can do it. Nana, first Kadai Edutthavonne, I'm just telling you for that language part of it, I'm diverting from the topic. First one, the heroine, as a Christian princess, she can't have a bindi. So, it looks like a widow and or a bad sign for a Tambram community. Lele, we'll put a cross instead. How people don't realize the truth. Apra ulla vandu paathina, Mary Mata, Yesunathar, everybody is speaking in Mylapore Tamil. Yesunathar paathela, people got so agitated that the screen was torn and chairs were broken and the people ran to Vasan and said, Vasan said, nobody talks about this movie hereafter. Bring it back and we'll burn the negatives. That's exactly what happened. And idunala enna aachuna, the same problem, then they analyze the problems. Brahmin language la Christian pesadhu kashtama irukku. Or 50s la vandu Vasan asked his people, why isn't Anand Vigdan selling so much when Kalki is? Kalki vandu appaye vandu used to write about the gounders in Poyman Karadu and my kadaila edha amstar for the wider audience. Appo vandu they told him, this Brahminical language is hitting us. Nonna, you write a novel, he gives it to Kothamangala Subbu, write a novel with no Brahmin in this. If you are including a Brahmin, you should be the villain of the piece. So that is how you get that Nagesh character. What is it? Vaidhi is the only Brahmin Thilana Mohanambal, and he is a Brahmin and idilla. So that is how this language affected. This was, of course, Rukmani, a very beautiful girl, Lakshmi's mother. And of course, you know Lakshmi's daughter Aishwarya and her voice. Evlo bad ah irukum voice nu theriyum. Rukmani vandu had to sing 16 songs in this movie. Okay? She sang. And she sang like a barn owl in great distress. I can keep adding the adjectives, in great distress. So, modhalla enna aachuna, what AVM was worried about was, he shot this movie, first rendu vari. He shot this movie in the Vijayanagaram Palace. Mandavelila and the Admiralty Hotel irukla. And the king had committed suicide 1 year earlier. everybody was seeing the thing at 6 o'clock in the evening. So, you know, nobody wanted to live there. They went off. It was for rent and they picked it up. AVM picked it up. Upon the Prakriti movies. Upon the Sri Valley Edukrappo, what exactly happens is the elephant on the Thukra scene, Bayandruvala. So, they borrow the elephant or hire the elephant 6 months ahead. அதை வந்து அதே ஸ்டுடியோவில் கட்டி போட்டு ஷீ இஸ் ஆஸ் டு கோ அண்ட் கிவ் த கிராஸ் ஆர் கரும்பு டெய்லி அண்ட் பை த டைம் த சீன் கம்ஸ் த எலிஃபென்ட் அண்ட் ஷீ ஹவ் பிகம் கிரேட் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஸோ எலிஃபென்ட் தூக்குற சீனில் ஷீ ஷுட் ஆக்சுவலி ஆக்ட் ஸ்கேட் ஷீ இஸ் லாஃபிங் அண்ட் கிக்லிங் கொஞ்சம் பயப்படுற மாதிரி ஆக்ட் பண்ணுமான்னு டைரக்டர் ஹேட் டு மென்ஷன் பட் இந்த படத்தில் இன்னொரு இது வந்து என்னதுன்னா இட் வாஸ் அ சூப்பர் ஹிட் இன் த விஷுவல்ஸ் பட் இவ்வளோ பாட்டு வந்தோடனே எல்லாரும் காதில் கையை வச்சு தே ஸ்டார்டட் ரன்னிங் அவுட் I think the tradition of going out for a smoke when a song comes started with this movie. அப்போ வந்து AVM did not know because he actually pledged his house to take this movie. என்ன பண்ணணும் தெரியல. So, டக்குன்னு அந்த படத்தை எல்லாத்தையும் தியேட்டர்லேருந்து he called back. And he called Periyanayagi to sing the songs and dubbed it post-production. That is after the movie had been released. I think this was the first time that anybody dubbed the movie after it had been released. அப்போ வந்து it was a very small factor. The movie became a very big hit. And AVM went laughing all the way to the bank. But the political or the other impact is, you need not sing to become a hero or a heroine. That started, that was enforced in the mind. So when MGR was doing a Sevagan role,
or Shivaji could orate in the theatres,
could all get chances. One or 50 people waited for them. Padat theriyillengra ore kaaranathinala indha padathukku apparam they moved. Though I am moving out of that, and then the relevance is solved so that you can look into this. This was of course Chandralekha. Chandralekha vandu Vasan was a guy who used to say you need a tempo in movie. Tempo ngra vaartha Vasan romba pidikum. Ashokamithran vandu used to write Vasan can give even a railway timetable tempo. Avlo or used to get in things to add tempo to the movie. So Chandralekha vandu paadi padam eduthaachu. Chandralekha oda basic history appadina இந்த ஸ்டோரியை வந்து முதல்ல சொல்கிறாங்க வேப்பத்தூர்கிட்ட வந்து சொல்கிறாரு இந்த ஹீரோயின் வந்து வில்லனோட மூக்கை வெட்டி மிளகா பொடியை திணிச்சு அப்படியே ஜன்னல் அப்படி தூக்கி போட்டாரா வெளியில் ஸ்கிரிப்டை வெளியில் போ அப்படின்னா வென் வேப்பத்தூர்கிட்ட வென்ட் அவுட் சைடு கதவு திறந்தப்ப அந்த ஹீரோயின் பேர் என்னன்னு சொன்னேன் இட் வாஸ் 1944 இந்த ஹீரோயின் பேர் என்ன சொன்னேன் அப்படின்னா சந்திரலேகா சார் நானா சந்திரசிரேகான்னு எழுதி வச்சுட்டு இவெண்ட் ஆஃப் த மூவி வாஸ் மேட் இன் 1948 தே கெப் லுக்கிங் ஃபார் ஸ்டோரி ஸ்டோரி ஸ்டோரிஸ் அண்ட் கெப் சேஞ்சிங் த ஸ்டோரி சோ மெனி ஆஃப் இதில் வந்து த எலிஃபென்ட்ஸ் ஆர் த சர்க்கஸ் வேர் நாட் இன் சந்திரலேகா ஒரிஜினல் ஸ்கிரிப்டில் மூவியில் டெம்போ இல்லைன்னு சொல்லிட்டு தே வாண்டட் டு ஆட் ஸோ ரெண்டு சர்க்கஸ் சேர்த்தா நல்லாயிருக்கும் இதே மாதிரி தான் 1950s இந்த ஒரு குரங்க சேர்த்தா நல்லாயிருக்கும் ஜிப்பிங்கிற குரங்கு கொண்டு வந்தாங்க ஸோ இதில் அந்த குரங்கு வந்து இந்த இது வந்த உடனே யானை ஒரு சர்க்கஸ் அது வந்து தே லாட் இம்பார்ட்டன்ஸ் கிவன் டு திஸ் டூ சர்க்கஸஸ் கேம்ப்ட் இன்சைட் வாசன்ஸ் ஸ்டுடியோ ஆன் மவுண்ட் ரோட் ஒன் ஆஃப் தெம் சேஞ்ச் இட்ஸ் பரசுராம் சர்க்கஸ் சேஞ்ச் இட்ஸ் நேம் டு ஜெமினி சர்க்கஸ் ஆஃப்டர் திஸ் Gemini Circus and the time of Mount Road you could see a lot of elephants going out for walks coming in people used to come in to see the elephants so on Mount Road and of course Vasan vandu went on to take make a OIR we'll have to play the second video that the voice kutta mari vaparu இதெல்லாம் அப்படியே ஸ்டன்னிங் சீன்ஸ் அந்த காலத்தில் ஜஸ்ட் இமேஜின் 1950 இல்லை இல்லை அதில் அந்த சவுண்ட்ஸ் கம்மி பண்ணுங்க அதெல்லாம் ஒரு ஸ்டோரியே இருக்கு So many elephants he could muster so fast. இது வந்து அந்த ஒரு கார்ட்போர்ட் ஃபோட்டோ அது எப்படின்னா யூ கேன் புட் இட் ஆஃப் ராஜாஜி சீஸ் திஸ் மூவி ட்வைஸ் அண்ட் ரைட்ஸ் அ குட் ரிவ்யூ அந்த மூவி கோஸ் இன் டு கிரேட் ஹிட் பிகமிங் கிரேட் ஹிட் ஆஃப்டர் ராஜாஜி சீஸ் ராஜாஜி ஆனால் ஒரு அந்த காலத்தில் சின்ன பையனாக இருக்க போது சொல்லுவாங்க ராஜாஜி மூளை அப்படி மூளை அவர் மூளை எடுத்து மியூசியத்தில் வச்சுருக்காங்க அப்படிமாங்க செத்து போனதுக்கப்புறம் ராஜாஜி வந்து டேரி எழுதிட்டார் horrible movie so bad to see the cardboard forts and cardboard bridges falling after elephants ellaji vechipada rajbhavan gandhi re kadichiruchu and he printed it in 1990s so rajaji wrote about very badly about this movie idhila enna na kbs of course and this elephant scene the elephant pathingla these elephants actually came from coorg to madras to be sent to the andamans Appo there was a need for elephants in the Gemini studio. So the elephants were all taken to Gemini studio for 1 week. They shot the cinema and they were driven from there straight to the Madras port to Andamans. And the paint adichanaala dhaan verum ubudina avlan irukadhu. So studio la white paint adichadhu appadiye couple la yetra varaikkum it was there. And Gemini used many elephants for a later movie, Avvayar. Elephants were being transported from Coorg, taken to Andaman by ship. Madras la irukapo, there was a need for many elephants and sacred vibhuti markings on the forehead. Actually, the hero of this movie was, one of the important characters was Gemini Ganesh, who was working then at the Gemini studio. He is the prince who marries Pari's daughters. Odane, they rush back to the harbour to catch the ship. And Shivaji Ganeshan, reportedly had an elephant in the next road. He had an elephant. Vastu wise, it was bad. He had tied the elephant in the northeast corner and lost a couple of movies due to that. And then he gave the elephant a different one. Vellayamma. Where do you find the character Vellayamma? Veerapandiya Kattabomman. Veerapandiya Kattabomman la Vellayamma. This elephant was donated to Punainallur temple and Shivaji found it very lucky donating elephants. So there and four temples he donated elephants after that. It was in the big temple in Tanjore. Of course, they were films, made a lot of elephant movies. Orphan, appa sithu poitaanga, ivanukku saapaadikkala, but used to have four elephants as pets. And the storyline la India la mattum edha mudiyum. Indha naalai namade, I mean, nalla neram raathi mere saathila, or anade will bring up four elephants. And this is a very crucial part of elephant history in South. Enna building theriyuda? Egmore station. Elephant theriyuda? Egmore station la elephant. The logo of the South Indian Railway had an elephant as a symbol. We can still see it in the Egmore railway station. The badges that the porters wore are South Indian Railway. Illa enna na, and much later ippo vandu logo is bolu nu somehow they, I think, it was a guilt feeling. I think the railways killed more elephants in Assam and other things, so there was a guilt feeling that they put the elephant in there. Elephants were major employees of the South Indian Railways. World War II, new tracks were being laid all over West Asia. Jordan, Syria, Iran, Iraq, all. So, the locomotives were required much faster for the World War II. Just enough engines to drive the trains. So they didn't have for shunting and all that stuff. The entire shunting operation of South Indian Railways was done by elephants. So pushing these empty wagons, pushing them into line, ellame. There are plenty of photographs in the railways archives. Mesopotamia, many elephants were on the payroll and some were even pensioned off. Another thing is, so 1900s, you had a pet elephant, you could take it on a train with you. The ticket was 600 rupees. They would load an elephant in a carriage separately and you could travel in the train. So, a lot of Maharajas made use of it. 600 was very big because the third class ticket would have cost you 2 rupees or 3 rupees and a first class ticket would have cost you 10 rupees. 600 was a very princely amount. I think you would have hired a train for it. Madras High Court was the collector office is there in North Madras. It was called Supreme Court of Madras. Ella court in kadandu or case vandhudu. For several of almost 200 years, the longest litigation in Madras history was about an elephant. The elephant was not a Madras elephant, it was a Kanjivaram elephant. Enna naamo elephant ku podradu. Temples became proud owners of elephants and used them in processions. Most visible and attractive feature was their neck, forehead. Oldest running litigation in Madras is about an elephant where two groups of devotees of the Devaraja Swami temple in Kanjivaram have been fighting intermittently for right to adorn the temple elephant with a huge. Sariya, the litigation drew in the colonial government, the collector and the lower courts. Appeals were filed. 1857, we are bloody fighting a sipahi mutiny. But we were here, we are fighting a case for an elephant. So Madras was very, very advanced in the sense that we built our first dam in 1857-58. We had such a knowledgeable court fighting on this. The Tenkalai actually gets control of the, they get the verdict in their favor. So, why namam potranga? And one of my friends had gone to a temple and she said there is a why namam for that. Almost all temples are Tenkalai temples, most of the important temples. The why dam poduvanga, you romba rare. அங்கே யானை இருக்கிறது வசதி இருக்கான்னு தெரியல, டெம்பிளுக்கு யானை இருக்க வசதி இருக்கனால. ஸோ வாட் எக்ஸாக்ட்லி ஹேப்பன்ஸ் இஸ் த ஒய் நாமம் போடுறதுன்னு ஹைகோர்ட் ஆர்டர்ஸ், பட் த ட்ரஸ்டீஸ் தட் டேர்ன் ஆர் வடகலை வித் த யூ. வாட் தே டூ இஸ் தே டூ த ஒய் நாமம் அகார்டிங் டு கோர்ட், முன்னால் ஒரு சாக் கிளாத்தை போட்டு அதில் வந்து யூஓ போட்டுறாங்க. ஸோ த கோர்ட் ஆக்சுவலி ஃபைன்ஸ் தெம் 5 rupees அஸ் கண்டெம்ட் ஆஃப் கோர்ட். வி ஹவ் ரெக்கார்ட்ஸ் ஃபார் தட். அண்ட் ஃபார் 184 years ஃப்ரம் 1792 ஆன்வர்ட்ஸ் திஸ் கேஸ் வென்ட் ஆன். What was the final verdict? The court said, let's buy 2 elephants, 1 Y, 1 U, keep it. And the case was over. இதில் முக்கியமான என்னன்னா, நடுவில் வந்து ஒரு 30-40 years யானை இருக்காது, அப்போல்லாம் கேஸ் குவைட் ஆகிடும். Somebody will donate an elephant and the case will be taken up. Elephants, of course, are always, ஒரு மெட்ராஸில் பாரதிய கொன்னதுக்காக elephants are always accused, which is very, very wrong. It was just a part of his, he was already dying of malnutrition and poets always die of malnutrition. So that is one thing that catches all poets. Now when I do a Mylapore walk, I always point to Krishnasamy Iyer Avenue and tell them this is something that Mylapore always has to be ashamed of. Inga Bharathiyar nikka vachu Senthamil Nadanum and the part, there were only 12 chairs were occupied by all important people of Mylapore. Bharathi had to stand and sing that song. But who goes into history? Or important or interesting thing is, we located Bharati's horoscope, one of his Madras Literary Society, we located his horoscope. Yaarun sollama, I gave it to an expert astrologer. You wouldn't believe, he said this man vaalka fulla kashtapaduvar, but after that he will become a treated like a messiah or treated like a giant. He becomes a giant after death. Then I told him it was Bharathiyar. So avlo oru idhila Bharathi vandha had a very, very bad time in Madras. The most poetic of Madras inhabitants, Subramanya Bharathi, returned from exile in French controlled Pondicherry in 1919. Bharathiyaroda most of the songs, Bharathina triplicate nu solrom, Bharathiyaroda most of the songs were written in Georgetown and Blacktown verses nu paathina Paman Swamiyo, Vallalaro, Bharathiyaro, the best poetry has come from Georgetown. You even have this Tyagabrahmam coming and visiting, you have Sastri looking at the violin first time anga bandstand road la. So a lot of musical history in Georgetown. So if a triplicate la kadasi kaalathula varappa, he goes to this Tulasinga Perumal Coil Street la irukkaru, yaanaiyum palam vaangi saapradha avaru budget irundirukum paavam. 1921 July la it was under must and he went theriyam pakkathula ponaonna ore or vaati trunk vachi adichiruchu. He fell down and he was frail, he could have stood but he was weak ingranaala he fell down and somebody rushed in, one of his friends or fans rushed in and lifted him out, and he had a cut on the upper lip, abrasions on the head, no life threatening injury he had. At the following days he has gone to the same temple and fed the same elephant. We have records of him feeding the elephant after those days also. In September he passed away. This happened in July, in September he passed away. So but and the 3 maasam kada we all forget and compress the whole thing and say that elephant adichu Bharathiyar eppadi settaarna onna yana oru chinna pulla kuda yana pagathula pogadu bayandu.
ஆக்சுவலி ஒன் திங் ஐ வாண்ட் டு ஆட் இன் திஸ் சார், இதில் வந்து ஆக்சுவலாக வந்து இந்தியாவில் வந்து சுதேசியில் வந்து பாரதி எழுதியிருப்பாரு. ஸோ யானைக்கு நான் யாருன்றது தெரியாது, தெரிந்திருந்தால் அடித்திருக்காது, நான் விழுந்த உடனே அது என்னுடைய பார்வையும் அந்த பார்வையில் அது வழி
தெரியும். This was a contraption, sorry to anybody from IIT Madras here. This was one of the earliest missions designed by IIT Madras to lift a baby elephant onto a British Airways flight. You will have to put the last video to the mission was designed at 1.5 lakhs and you need to see the video. Now the next one, how the elephant got down from the plane ngada neenga paakanum yerradhuk IIT help vendi irundhathu. Padila irangi vandirchi pesama. So with that I come to the end of this talk. I think I didn't overshoot the time, that's just correct.